So we are very proud of all of our participants, but a particular shout out to our music teachers, nod to Phil Villalobos, who helped organize and lead the band. The first year we were in the parade, we had 75 students who participated, and this year we had 150 students participate. Mind you, there was a gap of instruction while our kids were in distance learning. So we're very proud of our students and their parents for their continued support. And then in closing, we're really excited about, we've always had this great partnership with our Assistance League. They support our new teachers and our BITSA program. But through that relationship, Susan Kelleher-Holtz has been kind of a liaison between the district and the Assistance League. They've always wanted to figure out how can they support our families through Operation School Bell, which is an organization that started to provide uniforms for our students. They've struggled with space and organization, so we were able to, with the work of several people throughout the district, reserve a room, a space over at Key, where they have a storage of uniforms so they can buy them and have them on hand. They're just for Anaheim Elementary Schools, and on November 8th was their first distribution. They came out and the volunteers from the Assistance League organized over 120 kits for students, and in those kits there are two pairs of pants, two polo shirts, a sweater, socks, undergarments, and a gift card to purchase shoes. And what happens is the volunteers come out, they organize it, they label it by school, and then at the next meeting where we have our faces in attendance, they will go pick up the bags and distribute them to our families. So a special shout out to Susan Kelleher-Holtz. She's in the HR department. Leslie Kazarian, she's our main contact with the Assistance League. Parent leader Maritza Bermudez is the president currently of the Assistance League. Our AESD M&O team, our AESDS face office, and Anna Williams for helping everybody make this happen. And that concludes our report for tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Grace. Okay, we're moving on to agenda item 7. Which is the superintendent's report. And we will have an AESD safety update by Tracy Golden, our Senior Director of School Safety and Operations.
Good evening, members of the board. I'm pleased to be here to talk about safety. Safety is a priority for us here in the district, so we are committed to ensuring that all our students and our staff, no? Okay, so I thought so. We're committed to ensuring that all of our students and staff feel both physically and emotionally safe at all of our schools. Physical safety is not only the physical environment around us, but it also is the procedures that we have in place. So at all of our schools, we have the Raptor check-in system so that every one of our visitors who do not work on that campus are checked in through the office. We also have our volunteer screening program, which is for volunteers who are coming onto campus with a little more, for a little more time or possibly working with students directly. We are also in the process of upgrading all the exterior fencing at all of our schools, including privacy screens, especially those fences that are maybe facing out into the city parks or maybe a busy street. Also, all of our schools are a single point of entry, so anyone that is coming onto our campuses are going through the office and going through that Raptor system. Also, we want to ensure safe ingress and egress at our schools, so our staff is consistently reviewing how students arrive on campus, how they leave campus, and also safe routes home. We also want to ensure that our students are feeling emotionally safe in a welcoming environment at our campuses. We have several programs and curriculum that we use in the classroom that includes or touches on topics such as emotional management, empathy, respect, responsibility, anti-bullying, conflict resolution, and mindfulness. And we want to make sure that all of our students have these skills so they can interact in the world in a healthy way. We also have a cost team at every one of our sites, and those include psychologists, our counselors, our behavior intervention aides, our behavior health aides, which are our Western youth personnel, and then also our villages clinicians. We also make sure that we have ongoing prevention throughout the year. Every year, our staff is trained on the social-emotional curriculum and programs that we have. Also, emergency and disaster response. Also, every one of our employees is a mandated reporter, so we make sure that we have mandated reporting training every year for everyone. Our schools are updating and reviewing their safety plans, their school safety plans. They do that every year, and they create goals for their school around safety. Four times a year at every school site, there's a safety committee that discusses safety issues that are specific to their school site. Also, we have building and grounds checklists that happen quarterly, and that's just to ensure that our physical grounds and physical buildings are safe, maintained, and anything that needs to be fixed or changed, we make sure that we do that to make sure the environment stays safe. Also, we do emergency drills throughout the year, fire drills, lockdown drills, earthquake drills. Every one of our schools participated in the Great Shakeout last month in October. Most of our schools, or many of our schools, share a border with a city park, and so we work in collaboration with the city of Anaheim to ensure that issues on both sides are resolved, whether it's on the school property or the city property. So we encourage anyone who has any concerns about safety that are happening on our school sites to contact the principal and vice principal, because they can address those issues at the schools. For issues that are happening in the city parks or maybe on city property that we don't have jurisdiction of, we really encourage everyone to contact either the city of Anaheim or use the Anaheim Anytime reporting system, or if it's something that's an emergency and needs immediate attention, that we call the Anaheim Police Department. And that concludes my report, so I just want to open it up for questions if anyone has any.
Board members, any questions or comments?
Just out of curiosity, do we still utilize lock blocks?
Yes. Okay. So classroom doors are locked, and then they have the lock block so that if they need to lock down quickly, they can just pull it and pull the door shut and they're locked down.
Yes. Perfect. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And I apologize for skipping an item, so I'll just go back one. It was the public speakers on agenda or non-agenda items, but there are no public comments submitted, correct? And then we just had agenda item 7. Now we're on to the consent calendar, item agenda 8. Items listed under the consent calendar are considered to be routine and are acted on by the board in one motion. There is no discussion of these items unless a member of the board, staff, or the public requests specific items to be discussed and or removed from the consent calendar. Are there any items, in addition to item 8A5, which was tabled and postponed by administration prior to the adoption of the agenda, that need to be pulled? Trustee Lopez? Trustee Magalas? And I don't have any either. So may I have a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. So the motion carries 3-0. Now on to the action calendar, 9A, the superintendent's office. It is recommended the Board of Education receive for first reading revisions to the following board policies and administrative regulations.
So moved.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
So that's 3 ayes. Item 2. It is recommended the Board of Education received the draft January 2023 to June 2024 board meeting schedule for first reading revisions. The final schedule will be brought for approval at the December 14th, 2022 annual organizational board meeting.
So moved.
May I have a second?
Oh, sorry, second.
And for discussion, I'd like to call on Dr. Downing.
Thank you, Acting Board President Philbeck.
This item is being brought for the board's approval because we did a comprehensive comparison of our district and the board meetings that were taking place in comparison to other districts in Orange County. What we found is that every single elementary district in Orange County has one board meeting per month. Our neighboring high school district has one board meeting per month, and the overwhelming majority of the districts within Orange County have one board meeting per month. And it's our goal to align our practices to our other sister districts, if you will, and we are presenting this comprehensive schedule for the board's approval. You will note that when there are compliance items that are due, such as in June, there will be two meetings, but we feel confident and look forward to supporting this new schedule in collaboration with our board.
Thank you. Do either of you have any other comments?
Yeah, I had one comment I wanted to make because I know as part of our duties annually, we also are ex officio members of several different boards and commissions. So I think this is a benefit in that sense that, for example, City of Anaheim Parks and Recreation Commission, we always have a conflict every month. So that meets on the fourth Wednesday of every month at 6 p.m. So it will actually free us up to other meetings that we've been missing. So thank you for the recommendation from staff.
Yes, I think I served on that. That was one of the first things, the Park and Rec, and I was not able to attend one meeting because they were the same nights as our board meeting. I mean, I got information from them for reports and things, but we just weren't able to attend. So thank you for in-depth explanation, Dr. Downing. Okay, we're moving on to educational services.
We had to vote.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, we have the first and the second.
Yeah, and I did also want to comment also, I think it's a cost savings for us as well, with our staff time and resources, so I appreciate that as well. As always, thinking outside the box. Thank you, Dr. Downing.
And thank you for recognizing that as well.
We've already had a motion, a second.
Yes, I believe you were the motion and Dr. McGloss was the second, so all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. So that's carries 3-0. Now on to educational services, which there are none. SELPA, none. Human resources, D1. It is recommended the Board of Education approve the new job description and recruitment for teacher on special assignment, professional development educator support. Did I miss one? Okay, I'm reading my script here. That was my next one. Do you have something different? Oh, it's hard to get good help. That's all I can tell you. Be patient with me. I haven't done this in about 4 years. Thank you. I apologize again. Okay, so let's go back to 2. It is recommended the Board of Education received the... No, wait, I already did that one. That was for the... Oh, okay. Got it. I'm on board now. It is recommended the Board of Education accept nominations for the California School Board Association, CSBA, Delegate Assembly for Region 15. CSBA delegates serve 2-year terms. Those elected in 2023 will serve beginning April 1st, 2023. Do we have a motion, please?
So moved.
Discussion?
If you would, so right now we are nominating, Trustee Philbeck, if you would like to continue this process, I would like to nominate you, but it's up to you.
Thank you. I do plan on resubmitting for the position and for Region 15, so thank you.
Then I nominate Jackie Philbeck to continue in Region 15, or the CSBA delegates to serve another 2 years.
Thank you.
I will enthusiastically second that motion.
Okay, thank you. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
So it carries 3-0. Okay, so now am I correct by moving on to the educational services, which we did none, SELPA none, human resources. Okay, sorry for getting this all mixed up. Okay, so now the one I was starting to do was the new job description, and that's the correct one. Okay, it is recommended the Board of Education approve the new job description and recruitment for teacher on special assignment, professional development, educator support. This position shall be placed on the certificated salary schedule based on 184 days effective November 10th, 2022. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Carries 3-0. It is recommended the Board of Education approve the new job description and recruitment for Senior Director of Human Resources. This position shall be placed on range 17 of the Certificated Management Salary Schedule based on 220 days effective November 10th, 2022. Motion, please.
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Carries 3-0. It is recommended the Board of Education ratify and approve the submission of a variable term waiver request for employee number 1109-2022-01, effective November 1st, 2022 through June 30th, 2023. This waiver will allow the speech and language specialist to continue services to students while completing clinical fellowship requirements. Motion, please.
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion on this item? No? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Carries 3-0. On to administrative services. There are none. Agenda item 10. We moved through this pretty quickly, guys. Board discussion. So even with me messing it up a few times, we still moved through it pretty fast. So board member activities related to school business, and let's start with you, Trustee Lopez.
Thank you, Acting President Philbeck. Just want to start off by saying October 27th, I was able to attend our wonderful, amazing junior high school showcase with Anaheim Union. Dr. Grace was there as well. Some of our other staff helping facilitate at Orange Grove, where we had all of our feeder junior high schools were there with pop-ups, easy ups to showcase all of the different pathways that they have. I think it was a great collaborative effort between our districts to show what they have at their school sites and their district, and for us to welcome our families and use our space at a familiar place for our families to come and not only learn about the school district where their sixth graders will soon be attending, but also get some great food. There was a lot of great entertainment by some student performers who were there as well, so it was a great time. October 28th, I was able to attend, I know Trustee Philbeck was there as well for a period of time at the Dia de los Muertos event at the Downtown Community Center. Many of our schools were there. I know some of the presentations stole some of my thunder, but so thank you for that. But it was a great opportunity to be able to at least kind of look at the different altars for a brief period of time, because I know we had another event immediately after that. I was unable to stay for very long because we had the Orange County Teacher of the Year celebration. So I did want to congratulate two of our educators who were recognized for all of their great work that they do in the classroom and with their students, Tran Palizzo from Orange Grove and Socorro Vargas from Adelaide Price. And I know Dr. Magalis and I were at that same table with Ms. Vargas. So a great conversation, great presentation, and being able to really celebrate what all of our educators do. And I know they don't do it for all the recognition, they don't do it for the being in the limelight, but because it's their calling and it's something they love, they enjoy doing, but it is important, I think, to recognize all their efforts as well. October 29th, most of us attended the Anaheim Fall Festival. I somehow got the short stick had to assist Trustee Rellis with the banner. I didn't drop it, not even once, so I consider that a success. It was great, and didn't get hit by any golf carts, which was another great success. So I was 2-0, so I don't want to press my luck any further than that. But it was great seeing all of our families, all of our students who were out there. I didn't get to hear all of the band behind me. We're kind of the tip of the spear on the parade route. But it was a great time to see all the community members, and there must have been, I don't know, 1,000 people along the parade route. There were quite a few people, 4 or 5 people deep. for the entirety of the route. So it was great. I want to thank all of our staff for helping organize that. There's a lot of logistics that go into it. So I'm pretty sure we're already preparing for next year because there is just so much that goes into it, just the staging, transportation. Thank you, Dr. Grace, for helping, and Mr. Chavarria for bus transportation for all our families. I know, and I know Ms. Mellon, you were there, Dr. Downing, helping to get all of our families placed on the buses, having buses coming back to drop off families. So there was a lot involved. So I do want to thank all of our staff, all of our bus drivers for safely getting all of our families to and from the locations we needed to be, and all of our staff who participated in the parade, and families who were able to make it as well. November 3rd, I was able to attend a meeting at Betsy Ross Elementary. Ms. Isela Vasquez also joined me at this meeting to discuss traffic concerns at Betsy Ross. Some of the families had, and parents, community members had some questions. There were approximately 20 community members who attended. I wanted to thank Ms. Darash for keeping the lights on for us. The meeting went a little longer than I think was originally scheduled, but we wanted to make sure everybody's questions were answered. And I want to thank city staff, City of Anaheim, for sending, I think they had 5 different staff members who were on hand to address any questions and provide resources to all of the community members who attended. Next, I just also wanted to, because it was part of the presentation earlier, as was mentioned with our school psychologists and social emotional support, it's National School Psychology Week this week, so I do want to recognize all of those staff members that we have at our sites who provide the social emotional resources and provide for the well-being of all of our scholars at each of the sites, and thank them for all the work that they do. I know it is a lot that goes into it, and making sure that we are addressing the needs of the whole child, the social emotional component is a big part of that. So I just want to recognize all of our school psychologists and all those who assist with the social emotional well-being of our students. And then I want to just close with an announcement for next week. There is a Boys in Park improvement meeting on November 16th at 6 p.m., which will be at the Anaheim Methodist Church, I believe, on State College, and Wagner. So I just want to close with that. With that, I'll close my remarks. Thank you.
Okay, Dr. Magalis.
Yeah, like Trustee Lopez said, I did attend the Fall Festival. It was very fun driving the golf cart around, and I would like to apologize to all the kids. I wish we could have given everybody candy, but it was just way too difficult for me and Trustee Philbeck to give everyone candy, but it was just so fun to see everybody. Jesse, I did bring the key back, right? So the golf cart is in good hands, no dings, everything's good, right? Okay, good. So it was so much fun, and I did attend the Teacher of the Year. I think it's important that we thank Schools First for hosting that event, the annual event to honor our amazing teachers and all the nominees as well throughout Orange County. So congratulations to our 2 Teachers of the Year. We're very proud of you. I'm also happy to announce in March 2023, I believe, my second publication was accepted. It will be in the Journal of Ethnic Studies Pedagogies. So I'm very excited to share that information. And that's all I have to share about my report.
Well, congratulations for that. As already noted, yes, I attended the Dia de los Muertos at the Downtown Community Center, and I absolutely loved it. The altars were beautiful. Was it Price that had the animals? Do you remember? I think it was, I don't know, one of them had the altar for the animals. And since I had just lost one of my little guys after 19 years, you know, it made me feel, oh, I just thought that was really sweet. So, but they all were beautiful. They were excellent. And boy, I was really proud for all of the schools that represented us during that. And yes, we did rush to Teacher of the Year right after that. And I'll just echo all the comments that were made. We're really proud of our Teachers of the Year and the nominees. And also I have noted Schools First too. We really appreciate They do a lot of things for us, actually, during the year, not just hosting that banquet, but they're just real partners with us, and so it is noticed and it is appreciated. And the parade, which was so much fun, there was a lot. I did ride the golf cart with Dr. Magalis driving, and all I can describe it as, have you ever been on Mr. Toad's Wild Ride? That's kind of like, I mean, we were doing spins in the street, and or like somebody had said, it was like the electrical parade, and I think it's like little snails that go out there and they spin around. Well, that's kind of what it felt. But excellent driver. He didn't toss me once. Might have tried to, but no, didn't toss me once. We made it through, and we did have a lot of fun. And boy, were there a ton of people there. And we were AESD proud, I can tell you that. I don't know, do we know how many we had in that parade? Over 450. We were a force in that parade. And you know what? We got a great reception, and the band was great, and it was just really a fun evening. And, you know, thank you also to all of the volunteers that put that together through the city and otherwise, and to our wonderful cabinet and staff and everybody that organized us. I mean, when you think about it, organizing that many people to be in a parade, that's a lot. So, and it was, I would say, seamless. I never saw anything that went wrong. It was just, so thank you so much. I also just zoomed in on or joined in on the district-wide all staff development day to hear Dr. Victor Rios, who also was a speaker at our CSBA conference last December, which is coming up again. And it was really great. I'm proud that our district has these opportunities for the staff development and for the efforts that go into making that happen. And also, as Board Member Lopez said, School Psychology Awareness Week. I'll just echo his comments. Thank you to our school psychologists and all those that participate in their mental health and wellness. We are greatly appreciative of you, and we recognize that your job is probably harder now than it ever has been. And so we're grateful for you to be here and partnering with us and helping all of our students and their families through some of these tough times. Okay, so that ends my report. Are there any future agenda items?
Thank you. I had one request at a future budget presentation, or whenever it's convenient. Yesterday we did have an election. One of our state ballot measures, Proposition 28, was regarding increase of spending on arts and music. And I just wanted to get a brief report on what impacts that will have for our district. That's all. If there's any clarification, please let me know.
Anything else? Okay, before we adjourn, we have someone very special that has a birthday tomorrow. Dr. Grace, we appreciate you. And, well, happy birthday. Next week, okay, well, we're gonna do Dr. Grace right now, and we're gonna appreciate you with song, and I'm gonna pick up the pace a little bit, guys, because we kind of tend to drag on these songs. So are you ready? Okay, ready? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Dr. Grace. Happy birthday to you. We really hope you have a wonderful day, Mary. And do you have to work? Yeah.
She can have Friday off.
Yes. Okay, all right. Everybody heard it. Yeah. Okay, well, have a great day, and we do appreciate you. So with that, our next regular board meeting is Wednesday, December 14th, 2022, and I will adjourn this meeting at 7:19 p.m. Thank you.